Alright, so the first wrong presentation is something like that. I write in red, so red means wrong. Wrong. The first wrong one is you tell me 1 minus 2x cubed straight away equals to 3 bracket 1 minus zoo. Are you listening? Thank you. Now, this is wrong. So this is wrong. Why? There is no way something cubed equals to something squared. No way. What you are trying to tell me is, after I differentiate, you get this. But you cannot present it this way. Okay? So this is the one that is wrong. Now, the second one is wrong. Is you write something like that. D over dx equals to 3, 1 minus 2x square minus 2. B. This is wrong because you are differentiate A. Now what do I mean? You look carefully. This one means differentiate with respect to x. But what do you differentiate? Nothing. Nothing. So you cannot differentiate nothing and get something. You notice the right hand side all are the same. The right hand side is the correct answer. So you do have the correct answer. Are you listening? So you are getting the correct answer, but you're not presenting it the correct way. You follow? So this is wrong. Maybe I write the correct one below in green color. So how you should write is this. You should write d over dx bracket, copy the question. Then you get this. Do you follow? So by writing this way, you are telling me I am differentiating with respect to x, this function, and this is the answer. Now I show you the third common one that is wrong. Third common one, third common one is you do this. Again, I copy the right hand side because the right hand side answer is correct. But again, why this is wrong is because, oh my god, what is why? There's no why then. So how can this be correct when there's no why? So what you need to do is, you need to add a statement before this. And this is what we write. Let y be this. Now, out of the three method, of course, the first one is totally wrong. I prefer this method. That means, in any question, you first will write down, let y be whatever you see here. Then divide dx, simple. Okay? But if you choose not to, if you choose to be, can. But you make sure you write it correctly. Now, back to our question. What is this differentiation? What kind of differentiation is this? Is it the power? Is it the quotient, the product, the chain? What kind of? Don't know, never mind. Can you tell me how to differentiate? Chain rule is correct. Can you tell me how to differentiate?
Bring out the tree.
Then why you say you cannot do? Answer they are not the same.
What answer is
B? Answer is negative 6, then this bracket is square, no?
No, but behind it.
Oh, then the behind is wrong. This is the correct one.
This is the correct one.
Then you can. You must be able to tell me that it is the same lah. When you look at your answer and the other answer. When you look at this answer, then the final one, when you explain everything, you must be able to tell me it's the same. Okay? So, what is this rule? Is it product, quotient, power, chain, quotient? How many of you think is quotient? Hands up. One. Two, don't be shy. How many of you think this quotient? Hands up. One, two, three. Three of you. Dini, what do you think this is? You say no. Uh, Oh, you use for dark blue.
See, what do you use? You take the X. It's a like participate. Don't let it be I talk, then you all do your own things. Then might as well do a lesson, you all go library now and do your own things. Now, this part is important, so all drop your friend and participate in the conversation. Jing Yuan say, why not I take this X, I bring up, then now this become X power minus half. Then suddenly this become good. This becomes something like a product rule, am I correct? So I got three quotient rule, two product rule. The rest? Separate the fraction. Separate the fraction, not product rule, it's different thing. Okay? So right now, in your mind, there are actually three strategies. All look up first. First strategy is quotient rule. Second strategy is product rule. Third strategy is split function. Split fraction. You think? Product rule. You think? Split. Okay, now you notice something, all the three will give you the same answer. Okay? But according to my small book, I say avoid product rule. Avoid quotient rule when you can simplify. What did you say? Which one? You try quotient rule. So why avoid quotient rule is because quotient rule is irritating. Over second square, copy second, differentiate first, minus. Then after that, you have to simplify again. Do you follow? So can I show you the split one and how beautiful this is? Now, let's try split. Split means this. Split means... I didn't start the video.
Oh, you did it,
You never start or you never... I don't know, because my target is 5 minutes per video. This one seems like exceeded. I think I didn't split. I forgot. Can you start copying?
Split means copy beside your work. Doesn't mean your work is wrong. I just want you to see how this one will simplify your max steps by a lot. It will reduce your anxiety. Understand? Exam already so stressed. Quotient rule some more very stressed. Now from here, how do I simplify? First one. Okay. Bring out the square root x. Tell me the final one. 3 to the power of x power 3 over 2. So the first one is 3 x power 3 over 2. Second one, Joshua. Ashad, next one. The rest of you write, don't wait. Write your answer, then compare Joshua and Ursa's answer. Minus half. I didn't ask you to differentiate, no? I asked you to simplify. I asked you this one, I want to simplify. This one I know power is 1. This one I know power is half. So what do I get? Half. So the second one, x is just half. Ursa? Because this one is 1 over x half. Square root is half. If I were to bring up, I will make it minus half. Why you want to bring up? Because if you don't bring up, you can't differentiate. Can follow? Now after you do this, you realize that next step, dy dx. Easy already. Power come down, copy, power, minus 1, power come down, power, minus 1, power come down, power, minus 1. Now, why is this good? It looks ugly, but it's good. Because later on, usually the question will go on to find the square y dx square. And you realize that this is still a power rule. Can follow? If you do quotient rule, later the square y dx square, you got a quotient again. Quotient on top of quotient, you go crazy. Can follow? Can But is this the final answer? No, you got to beautify it. Change everything to positive index. So for example, the first one will be 9 over 2 x half. The second one will be 1 over 2 x half. The third one will be 1 over 2 x 3 over 2. And hashtag.